Hey there, YouTube. Okay, so I decided I wanted to just do a little bit of a modification to this today. And I wondered what it would look like in white. And rather than go out there and buy a white one, I figured I would buy a shell. Because you can buy these for a little over £13, and I think it's going to be a nice little touch, just to see what it's like. And not only will I get to see what it's like in white, I'll also get to strip it all down, this that is, and get to see what's inside. Now, I've already taken this apart once. I was having, well, one of those was every time I put my hands near it, I'd lose the GPS, and I understand now by talking to Hubsan in China that that's normal anyway. But I was a little bit worried, so I wanted to take it apart and have a look inside anyway. And I did. There's a cover between the GPS module, like I'm sure I've done this in the video already. Not this video that I've done already, like I'm gone back in time and started again, but I was pretty sure I made a video of me taking it apart. I have, I know I have, I just haven't put it up, haven't I? But I do this quite often. Because there's like a barrier in between the GPS and the rest of the clock, but it was quite low. That's what I did, was I pushed it all the way up and sealed it all right round nice and tight. And yeah, since then, apart from one time the other day when I was flying, where as it went over the head and past the back of me, when I tried to bring it down, it just continued to go away from me up. That's the only problem I've had with this recently. So, but it seems like it might be a bit of a mission to change this around, but I think it's going to be worth it. I think it's going to look quite cute in white. And as we've got a couple of few days of rain ahead of us, I've decided that I'm gonna swap it around now. So, let me position this camera, get this out of the bag, and we'll have a little look at what we got. I suppose the first thing that's going to be noticeable with this shell is it doesn't have the canopy. It doesn't have this little, I'm not sure what you call that, but this little bit here makes it look like his mouth. And it doesn't have a back door. There are no screws and bits and pieces. It is literally just the main body shell, upper and lower. There we go. Now, so far I've never seen the bottom of this like this, because down here is the camera and the transmitter module. The rest of it doesn't look like it's going to be too complicated. This is where the motor controllers go. So I'm hoping it's going to be a straightforward thing to do. Now, the reason why this has got these little white things here was it was just easy for me. I don't fly it in headless mode because to be fair, I don't use the GPS anymore either. I find it quite annoying. Altitude. I have to use altitude hold because I don't like the manual mode. I don't like the way it just shoots off up in the air. That's a bit freaky anyway. It's bad enough when it does that on occasion in altitude hold. But I'm hoping that'll just be a firmware fix somewhere down the line. But it's just for flying it around the line of sight. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. It's quite nice fun. I was out at the park the other day, 2 hours continuous flying pretty much. And I say continuous, you know, when the battery runs out, I've got to swap over the batteries, but give it a minute or two to cool down, because it was once or twice. I put my fingers in the back here just to check the temperature, and a couple of times it was quite quite hot, and so I left it for 5 minutes just to cool down a bit. But generally, it was just like swap the battery out, put another battery in, get it going again. Which gave me a great test for my mod on my controller. I'm really pleased to say that I've had 10.5 flights out of my controller on a single charge, with still 7 volts left on the battery. So that's quite a good one. I think this is going to look quite cute in white. Quite cute, and it's going to be quite a nice little experience just taking it all apart and swapping it out. So let's get cracking with it. You got a whole bunch of screws to take out. And get yourself a tray ready. Let's put all those in. I will probably speed this up because there's not a great deal to sort of talk about on this. Just with the screws coming out. So from this point until I've got all the screws in that tray from the bottom here and the split, I will shut up and I shall speed the film up. Bit of a pain that one, but no man, we'll get it to come up. I think we can just start splitting that away. Split that away. Let's do that for safety. There we go. None of this seems to like to come out. Pretty sort of like straight, you can't pull it at an angle, it doesn't like that, it wants to all just come up evenly all the way around and come off nicely, you know. And then you've got a couple of connectors underneath here which I've hot glued in because I took them apart before. You just have to be a little bit, you know, sort of forceful, but not too forceful. And I'm just going to remove the hot snot on those just now. It actually comes with hot, and this is the layer, it's a bit of fabric, but it's like a shield layer, and like I say, it was like pretty much across the top of there, across the top of there, but sort of hanging down a bit, but I pushed it all up and made it seal in there, so I'll take that out again now. Oh, I can get it out, do quite a good job. This is the cover to the GPS. So I'm going to take that off. That's the shield. And this is sort of material, but if I just leave that there. And there's the GPS module. Now I'm going to whip this out. And I've got some tiny little screws in here. My light. Move the extractor fan out the way. It's got the so the GPS module is here, and this little tiny square module there, that's the compass. Now with this new board that I've put in, before I used to calibrate it, the compass, by the manual says the calibration is to hold it horizontally Oops. You know, like this. And then turn it clockwise twice. And then once you've done that, it will ask you to calibrate compass 2, and then you turn it this way, nose down, and do it anti-clockwise twice. But now, I'm going to screw that one out there somewhere, but I will find it. But now, sometimes it takes 2 or 3 turns, and sometimes it takes more, sort of 4 or 5 turns on the horizontal, not so much on the nose down part of the calibration. Now I'm not going to put these boards, and hopefully I've got another empty. I keep a couple of these empty, so when I build the little kits I can put the bigger parts and the smaller parts and ones. It's just easy for me to go up. So I'm going to put this, that's the GPS module, that's the bit that faces upwards with a little nipple on it. It's quite heavy as well, not heavy, but it's a solid unit, that is. It's quite interesting really. And this, around it, I don't know if you'll be able to see this, my camera's not very good, but around it there's some little, I don't know what you'd call them, but it's like it's got 2 edges to it, so basically the edge of this can fit in between them. There's one there, one there, one here, one here, one here. So I'll just put my light down again so I can see clearly. I'm going to put that back together. Double check it. Double check it and push it down. Look, pushed it down before. But dang it. Alright, just there. It's a little bit fiddly. That's it. But as soon as you get it lined up, it's simple enough, and then that literally just presses over and holds on top, so that's your GPS module. And pop it in there. Get that little screw, drop it in there. And this little tiny thing here, this is the compass. This is the bugger that causes. It didn't cause a lot of trouble, but that's the one that wants to be calibrated in every time. And there's only 2 screws in this, and there's only 2 holes, so it's dead easy to know which way to pull it round, put it back in again. Just make sure I get that screw out and check that unit in there. Let me just show you that again first. Look at that, look. Not a lot to it at all. Little tiny module. This job's quite important. Now these are the things that I don't know if it's going to be easy to get in or out. And because I didn't know, I decided to buy the spares. Now the canopy is the most expensive spare. In some places, I've seen them in the UK, some of these places like £4 plus. But Banggood, bless them. I think I've got mine for about £2.39. This was £1 something. So I figured if I couldn't get this out easy enough without damaging it at all, because I don't want to damage this, I don't want to break it, I want to keep this, and I'm going to give it a nice clean. I'm going to get the paper parts off it and give it a nice clean down, and it's going to be a spare shell. Just in case. Little marks. So if I can't get these out easy enough, if it seems like I'm going to damage them, then I'll just have to wait for the other parts to come in. I'll probably still fly it with the white shell without them. But we're going to see if we can get them out anyway. Let's give that a go now. I'm not quite sure. I'm not very confident at doing that because I don't want to damage it at all. And it does seem like it's quite a snug fit. It does, yeah. So I may just leave it. I may just leave those in and wait for the other ones to come. And also that's the same with the back door as well. Because I had been waiting for a back door, a white one, but it turns out that even though I ordered it, it wasn't going to arrive. Now that looks a bit more complicated to take that back door out than what I thought. It might be easy, it might be a case of me just having to twist that up and push it out, be a bit forceful with it, and to put it onto the other one. But the battery sticks in there quite snug anyway, when it's in. And knowing me, what I'll do is if I can't do it without sort of forcing it, I will just leave that in there and wait for the white one to come and just fit it at once, you know, to the white shell. And I'll still fly it. I'll just put a bit of tape, a bit of masking tape over it. The same as what I'll do on the canopy as well. I'll just put a bit of masking tape over the top if I was worried. But I won't take it out on a wet day or anything like that anyway, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. I'm going to move this magnet away from the rest of this, because I can't see it doing it any favours whatsoever. And I'm hoping that I'm going to be able to leave a lot of this intact. I'll probably have to take this out up here to get it through these holes. It depends how they disconnect. I may have to desolder from here. But we'll see how we go along on that. A little feed of these motors and just... But it's lovely. Like I say, you know, it's got a couple of few days of wet weather. It's been absolutely terrible today, but I've been so busy today. So what's next then? Let's have a look. I suppose I've got to disconnect everything from this board, all these extra wires, these power lines are marked up, so you can see it says positive, negative. I hope you can see that, but it does, it says positive, negative, so that's not going to be so difficult to put them back together again. Now, just for a fail-safe sakes, because I think this is always important when you do things like this, is because maybe you may get distracted, or it may be a few days before you can get back to it. Take pictures. Take pictures or run a video, you know, just so you got something you can go back to and have a look at. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm getting my phone and I'm going to take some snapshots. So I'm just going to just take my photos now, just so I get a good idea of where these leads go. If I do them all from the... Let's put these lights on. I've got no power over it and it's switched off, so no lights. Just so I don't get confused at all. I think that should probably be okay. If I just turn it down here, I'll just do it from this side. Just as an extra bit of a precaution. I'm just going to run the camera around, videoing, just so if for any reason I get distracted the way and for some reason my memory fails me, I've just got something to look back at. That should do it. Chances are I won't need it. But who we do need it, it's there. Right, let's have a look at this baby. We got a USB connection for the servicing in here. I don't know, that just comes out because I've taken it out before. And I say, yeah, I'm not taking it out, but it comes out to there now. I don't know if I need to disconnect that just yet. If I don't need to disconnect it, I'm not going to. This is going to be mainly about getting these out. I want to see how much of this I can leave intact. The camera and the transmitter for the camera is underneath here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take the screws out the top of here and just see how much play we have. Keep a check on these little screws as well, because we've got a few different types at the moment. They're the little tiniest ones for those, just for these boards. And the slightly bigger ones there are for this main board. And there should be, you'd think, one round here. There it is, hidden away. Okay, so that's four, and that's loosened that up quite nicely. Okay, now the wires are guided on their sides through here, and I'm going to note that it's the red wire. It may not make any difference, but just it's nice to put it back in. How it comes out. There's also some sponges here that's not in that case as well. So that's for the LEDs. This red, blue, red, white, blue, and black is for the LEDs. So I'm going to take those out of there as well. It's just nice and gently does it. Take those up out of the way. Bring this up. Out of the way. Okay, so we got a nice bit of play there, plenty of space. Now down here, is another connector, and that's got, like, you know, this black elasticy stuff, I suppose it is, on it. But I'm hoping that rather than me disconnect the one down the bottom, I may just disconnect this one here. I don't need to do that. These are the main controllers, because they've got big thick wires, and then you've got this thinner one here, but this one here seems to be for the camera, so I'm going to pull this out firmly but effectively to get it out, because then I can leave that camera module down there until I pull it up a bit further. So there's quite a bit of clearance space now to see what's going on underneath there, which is nice. There's the antenna. Now I wonder. I think there's some sort of way I can do an antenna mod on this. Put that antenna on the outside of this shell, maybe. Because it'll be easier if it looks like it's sealed. I don't know if you can see that inside there. I can bring this light down. I'm not sure. Where's my little freebie I got through the post that comes in really handy for this? Oh. Sorry about that. I'll probably cut that little bit out, or not, you know, just keep it the way it is. It's, you can see it down the bottom of there, look. That's the antenna. So, and that's connected by this black wire, which comes up to here. So this is the 2.4 gig transmitter, receiver. I'm wondering whether I can get the antenna out or whether I'm going to have to disconnect that there. I'm going to see if I can pull the antenna up, because that's got to come out anyway. And that looks like it's got some proper snot on it. I don't really want to pull on the wire as such. Let's just get underneath that and see what happens if I just give it a little bit of force. Well, not force as such, but I want to be able to move it. So, but what I'm going to do is I've decided I'm going to get rid of this bit of snot off there. And I'll take this off because it looks like it's going to be the easiest option. Just get that out of the way. So we don't have to worry about that. Okay, that gives us even more movement. Now, I think while that's like that, and that's pretty much all disconnected from the rest of it, I'm going to see about taking all this out now, these corners. Now the motors have got their own screws, four. I bet you I have to undo these just to pull those through, because I don't think I'm going to be able to get that through the hole. In actual fact, I'm convinced I'm not going to be able to, so that's going to have to come undone anyway. So as that's going to come undone, I'm going to take them out now. I'm just going to take off a little bit of just not if I can, or just pull them out. They do just come out. I can pull that through. There's one more little tiny wire there, and I don't quite know where that goes. Oh, that was that little single wire, wasn't it? Ha! And that goes. There's grass in it. This is where I've been flying it in the field. It's actually got grass in there. Now I wonder if those little wires are the same on all of them. Yep, and they're that's going underneath here. Underneath the camera module. So okay. I'll see what I'm gonna do then. I'm gonna see if I can just pull out one of these rubbers. We'll see how easy. There's going to be a few of those, so I'll just chuck that in. It's quite sticky. And if you use that again, that's good. Pull that out, just get them out of the way. Just so I'm just going to tack them just on the inside of this case, just so they don't become a pain in the butt anywhere. And I know then that the sticky isn't going to get covered in loads of, you know, just, well, anything. Or it won't attach itself to anything I don't want it to. So just stick them on the side of the case, but it just keeps everything into hand. Screw the one that I lost a little bit earlier. Gotcha. Okay. It's a lovely little board line. Yeah, the camera board is. I hope I don't have any problems repositioning the camera, getting the camera in. Right, okay, so where are we starting? We're starting off on this side, aren't we? Trying to figure out where that one wire goes. So let's have a look what we got in. I don't want to be sold at this. Really, if I don't have to. So, it was actually this one, wasn't it? So I already pulled this off. I don't want to desolder Anything if I don't have to, but I'm just wondering if I can get access to these screws on this board underneath, and I think I can, so I'm going to take out these screws. Okay, so there's one. It's a slightly thicker screw again. I've got to just take mental notes what screws go where. It's the same size as the top board screws, the main board, motherboard if you like. You know, 12 months ago I would never have done this. I'd have been scared stiff of breaking something. Another pair of tweezers, just to pop that out. Okay, now there's still a couple of screws there holding the camera. And there's some gunk on there as well, which looks like it's pretty thick gunk. I'll show you that in a second. Just look at the screws first. Keep in mind that's the same as the main board type screw. And that little plastic is just the cover for the camera. So I'll leave that go in there, not the screw into there. I've like got that yellow type gunk stuff keeping the camera in. That's not like the black stuff. The black stuff's quite soft, that's quite hard, more of a permanent fitting gunk, so that's a little bit worrying. I don't want to damage anything. I want to make sure I can put this camera back in exactly the right angle. And that same gunk stuff is the stuff that's holding the antenna in, the receiver antenna. Okay, right, let me see if I can just lift that board. Yep, I can lift it. And now it's still being held in there with something. Let's just take a little look. And it's possible that that's the antenna holding that down. Oh, I think I misspoke. Completely misspoke when I said there was a wire going down here. It looks like there's a wire. Look, when you first look, it almost looks like there's a black wire going down there, but that's not, that's part of the case. I'm just going to confirm that now by looking in this. There's a white line going down there, and that's why I've been mistaken as a wire in there. So really, if we go back to the one that I disconnected, which has come out now, which is brilliant. So that's one of my feet, and I wonder if it's going to make any difference. It is going to make a difference to which ones are which here. So I am going to. I'm going to mark these. I'm going to mark these with a little pen, which I have. And I'm going to call this RR, the rear right. And that can go in a little pot of little pot of goodies. I'm going to pull this out here because And hopefully that's just gonna come out there nicely. And that's front left. So we can go FL. FL. Right on this one. Front right. And this last one I won't bother marking because it can't go anywhere else but here because all the other ones are marked. Okay. A sip of my non-alcoholic beverage. I'm sorry about that. I can't live with the guilt. I just lied. It's very alcoholic. It's a premium 5%.
Okay, guys. For the sake of wrapping up this part of the video, of course, my camera's gone and done one again. You can see that. It says card error. The reason why it says card error is because now there's a file on there saying that there's been a fault. And until you get rid of that file, it won't actually read the card anymore. Nowhere in any of the instructions does it say this, and I will do a review of this camera because it is a piece of junk. Don't get me wrong, if you're only doing a very short video, it's okay, but this thing overheats dead easy. And I think that's what throws the error, because it is quite warm. It's very warm at the moment. So we were 5 minutes in, and so I've got to go back 5 minutes really. I'm not quite sure how far 5 minutes is back, so how much we've lost of the video. So let's go back to just taking a little look at this, because as you can see, I've not really had to desolder too much. I've not desoldered anything. I've undone the LEDs, these, as you know, and that's about it. But there is something I've just noticed that there's a washer there, and on that one it doesn't look like there's been any washers. On this one it looks like there's one there that's rusted on the bottom right, and at the top right it looks like there was a washer there. On this one again, there's a washer top right, bottom right, looks like there was one there. On this one it doesn't look like there has been any. And we've already done this one, haven't we? Yeah, bottom right, top right, nothing. So I'm not quite sure. And on here you can see there's a washer still there. I hope you can. This camera's terrible. I never realised how bad this phone camera was until now. So I'm really sorry about this, but we established that this was the aerial for the transmitter for the board, for the 5.8 gigs. And I'd had a little go. Let's just shift that out of the way. I'd had a little go at trying to just cut this gunk here. I don't know if you can see that little mark down there. Trying to cut it. It's very hard to cut. And in the camera there is also that same gunk. So I'm a little bit reluctant about doing that. I may end up leaving the camera in here, the lens, and looking at replacing the lens. Because I think I can get this out. And this is probably going to be the more expensive part to replace. And there's some hot glue there. I'm not sure of how this connects, but I can only hope it's not going to be terribly difficult. And I'm pretty sure I said that I'll do this in two halves. It'll be the take apart half, but let's have a look at it. And then we'll do another half of the video for putting it into the white shell. But I'm very disappointed with that camera. And although I've got my money back for it, because I showed them what it was doing, I made a video and showed them exactly what it was doing, and they just offered me my money back straight away, which is pretty good. They did offer to put it in my wallet at GearBest, but I said, no, it's okay, put it into my bank account, thank you, and I'll go and choose something else from somewhere else. But it's one of those, you know, if you've got a camera, you want it to work, don't you? It's no good if it only works for 10 minutes and then it starts throwing wobblers. So, let's not digress, let's just stick with what we're doing here. So, this is going to be the thing now. I don't mind taking a risk trying to take the 2.4 gig out. One, because I have a... Do I have a spare? I have the transmitter side. Now, let me think about this. This is... They're going to be two different aerials, really, aren't they? Okay, I'll have to have a little think about that. So this looks like it's going to be the most difficult part to get out. Just because of this gunky stuff. I don't know if I can warm this up. It is quite hard. It's like plastic. It's not like this black stuff. This black stuff's quite soft. It's like elastic, but a bit softer. Which makes it quite easy, not easy to pull these out, but they are pull-outable, that's not a word, I'm sorry, I'm just making English up as I go along, but you can pull them out, not without too much difficulty, but they are, it's good enough to keep them in there as well, you know, and have it works quite well, but this is quite rock solid. This is almost like as hard as this. So this is a different ball game. I don't know if there's some sort of solvent remover or something I can put on here to soften it. Whether it's a heating thing, maybe if I doubt if anybody will, you know, maybe know or even let me know. I say that's a bit negative, but. But we'll see, if I could maybe even work out what it is, I'll ask them at Hubsan actually, I'll ask the contact that I've got there, because they seem to be very good with me, and I'll see what they suggest. They'll probably think I'm nuts for taking it all apart, but hey, you know, that's all part of the fun of this stuff, isn't it? Get it, play with it, take it apart. I know there's a fella out there, old Mr. Davy Jones, gets it and just takes it apart anyway, so at least I'm playing with it first. So, and, you know, with this, like I say, with this connector here, this is more like just hot glue. Sorry if my fingers look a bit weird, but I don't know if you can see the scars down there. They got crushed when I was younger. And they split open like sausages in a frying pan with the bones out. Nice. That's a little bit weird. But I've got scars all over me. If I told you, you wouldn't believe. But anyway, that's. So I'm wondering whether I should just pull that off there and see what type of connector this is. Because that is literally just like hot snot, as we all know it. You know, hot glue, I should say. And then at least the board, then the transmitter board, will be separate. So then I've just got to worry about that camera, or like I said, I don't want to repeat myself, but this is what happens when your video camera lets you down, if you don't know whether you're going over old, you know, what you've said already or not. So I don't want to miss it out. I could maybe just leave the camera in, leave the aerial in, and just get Hubsan to send me a new camera, a new aerial, and fit it in the other shell, which also means then if I do go back to this shell, they're already in there. It's not a big problem, you know, it's not going to break the bank, these two. I can't see them costing that much. It's probably going to be cheaper than getting this actual transmitter board itself anyway, because it's got a lot more on it. So, and then I've got to figure out how to get this off. It looks like it may not be as difficult as what I'm anticipating, but it's just going to be a bit of a fiddle. Sorry that the light's absolutely terrible. Where's that little one? Oh, I just get that. So you can see that there. I'm trying to see what you can see through the camera, but that's what I've got to try and disconnect that and that. That snotty stuff. It's terrible yellow. Anyway, I think that's going to wrap it up now, because what is it here? It's got to be close on nearly 11 o'clock, 20 to 11. And I want to have a little beer, have a nice little relax, and get myself ready to get to bed. So, well, chaps, if you got this far, I hope you have enjoyed, and I will in the next video hopefully be able to wrap up the building of the next part. But I won't just pull these out if I can get them out and not show you or tell you how I've done it. I will take a bit of time. I'll send an email off to Hubsan now and just ask them what this stuff is and if there's an easy way for me to get it out, whether it's a heat thing, whether I need to use my soldering iron tip or something just to warm it up, because I've got no idea what it is. But I don't want to do any damage to anything. And I'll also get a price for the lens side and the antenna, just in case. Okay, right. I'll see you in the next part. Take care, thanks for watching.